गुड मॉर्निंग गुड मॉर्निंग सर गुड मॉर्निंग
लिसन अप हाउ आर यू मेघना रेनिंग आउटसाइड
यस सर
एंड इन आंध्रा आल्सो इट रेन्स दैट हेवीली और
यस सर इट रेन्स वेरी हेवीली देयर
वेरी हेवीली सो यू फाइंड इट डिफिकल्ट टू मूव अराउंड लाइक इन दिल्ली और इट इज बेटर देयर
Sometimes the water clogs, especially near the old Rajendra Nagar area. So over there is a problem. And apart from that, I observed Delhi temperatures kind of move very swiftly. So that was a little different.
You're based in where? Hyderabad? You have done electric and electronics from Warangal and Lucknow also, marketing management.
Yes, sir.
And your mother is working in SBI. Okay. Tell me this NPS, which bank is having the maximum NPS?
The State Bank of India.
State Bank. So are they giving it to that some new bank has been created, na? New facility?
The but, new bad banks.
So they have transferred everything to that bank or?
No, sir. It was given in the budget that they will be doing the asset reset companies, but it is not yet done.
But I think PNB has already done it.
I am not aware of
that. Okay. Tell me something about supply chain of this big e-commerce retailers and wholesalers like Walmart and all. How it functions? What are the all aspects they take into consideration?
So on a platform, startingly, we have the supply chain manager. The senior manager looks at the procurement. So while procuring, they will look at some aspects like the quality, the logistic cost that they will be having, and the demand. So by the data in e-commerce, the advantage they have is that they will be able to look at what kind of demand they are having. So one of my friend was working in Amazon. So he used to go to China, Taiwan to get products from there. Recently, with the new norms in India of wanting to have made in India, and the push for the small retail manufacturers. So they're also having a lot of suppliers from India itself.
How they ensure that once order is placed by a customer, that product comes at the same time and within that few hours notice?
Sir, mainly for a city like Mumbai, they have a big procurement center near Bhiwandi. And from there is where they have a lot of some acres of land to keep out to get all the material. And from there, within the city, in four stages they divide. And quality checks and everything happen in Bhiwandi. And once the product reaches one of their four centers in Mumbai, from there on they go on to Delhi.
But directly to the suppliers also they sometimes place orders that you particular person supply to here. Like in some places in Delhi and Noida and all, we get these supplies directly from the small suppliers.
Yes, sir. So it depends on the quality requirements and also the kind of market based or inventory based that they are having. So if they can trust the supplier like a Godrej or Tata, so they will definitely look for minimizing the logistic cost.
Okay. Tell me something about Hyderabad. When it was liberated?
Sir, it was during the Operation Polo in 1948.
That operation was done by?
So the Indian government, by police.
By police or army?
I believe it was the police.
It was army.
Thank you, sir.
Naxal problem is there in Telangana, but or in Andhra Pradesh?
Sir, initially it has started from the forests of Andhra Pradesh, but due to the land issues, especially in the northeastern Telangana in Khammam and Karimnagar, it had picked up very rapidly in those forest areas, the belt that we have in Khammam, Srikakulam and Visakhapatnam. And then it had moved slowly to the southern regions and it had spread till Karimnagar, Warangal.
So now less in Andhra Pradesh.
Sir, right now in Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, both have reduced to a maximum extent.
Okay. Suppose you are cabinet secretary. You are given this job by the Prime Minister. See that within 2 years, this Naxal problem should be solved. what steps you are going to take.
So can I take a few seconds to think? Sir, having certain limited knowledge about how Andhra Pradesh and Telangana dealt with it, firstly, sir, what our Honorable Prime Minister also says that we have to look at the development side. If the areas are well developed, then the Naxalism and the and the issues which arouse the extreme thoughts will not be coming to the youth as well. So that will be my long-term agenda. But in short-term, like how Telangana managed, the ground system of police have to be very strong. So the Greyhound example of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh have been very famous. And also, sir, extensive work by the Chief Minister and the political will in the state has been very helpful for the state. And also, sir, with Naxalism, the problem is that whenever a state takes an action, they immediately move to the next state. So interstate coordination within the police and having information from the locals, taking the locals into trust and having certain information about them is very...
But some Naxals, they don't want development. They want only extortion of money.
Yes, sir. So for them, certain police and law and order issues, we have to deal with that sake. But the people or the tribals in those regions where they are misled by the Naxals, we can make sure that they are not misled by developmental activities.
Yeah. You have done PGP in Lucknow.
Yes.
It is called as diploma only.
Yes, sir.
It's not a PGP.
Sir, unfortunately, I was the last batch to have PGP. Next batch, they are giving MBA.
Now they are giving MBA, right? And your certificate says PG diploma.
Yes, sir.
That's what you have written. Okay. So you are telling about e-commerce, no? What are the various methods of route optimization?
Sir, I'm unaware of the proper terms. I'm unable to recall. But in even in ITC, we used to do the route optimization. So, sir, it depends on the beat. We go by beat level depending on the city's density and the kind of demands that we are having. And sometimes we also have just in inventory JIT methods. So that is again another type of route optimization that we follow.
Okay, JIT method is good to optimize your inventory and reduce the cost. And in, during COVID, one of the major principles of management which got affected or impacted is just in time. Okay. So how companies like ITC could manage the supply chain in deviation from just-in-time?
Sir, in ITC, what we used to do in just-in-time was that we used to take we used to place orders in the market every day. So if we are not able to do that process, so what we will do is we will place orders every 3 days. And we will keep the inventory somewhere at a place which is costing us less, like the place up, away from the city, like Bhiwandi in Mumbai. Or
could you work out your any rough idea how much it cost because of the lockdown, your inventory management, extra cost it inflicted on your company? Any idea?
Sir, I would not be able to do that precisely, but I am definitely sure that the cost of land to keep the area and then the amount of transport and logistics cost, especially also the personnel, the safety and...
You are in creative head, you were creative head in your Lucknow days, right? Okay, now you are given a task of designing a campaign for preventing or preparedness of third wave of COVID. Just tell me 3 points, which 3 points you will focus so that you want them to be registered in the minds of the people.
Sir, one thing that I see in the newspapers also is that the Western nations where the cases are coming down, like how we are coming down, there is this idea of freedom. which is coming up. So I will want to work on that, because this is not freedom, and we are not this is what has led to the second wave for us. So I would like to give out this message that it is not freedom, rather we are still as a nation working, and that will be my first focus. And secondly, sir, I see that a lot of online education is happening with children, and children are one source of good information. Whatever they know, they always spread. So I think that we should come out with these norms that teachers, at the starting of their class, for 5 minutes, tell them that washing your hands is important, putting up a mask is still important. So even in the houses, we see if one or two persons are not so adhering to these, children always make sure that their parents are adhering to those things. And thirdly, sir, I think that it is not just our Honorable Prime Minister who has to remind everyone that we have to put up masks, but our media,
In the top, people from top, they don't care about wearing mask. For example, Home Minister is caught walking in the parliament without mask. How do you see these things as a nation? What is lacking in us?
Sir, I am assuming that parliament and the Honorable Home Minister must have taken certain guidelines and by going into the parliament certain way. But the larger message that he has taken the guidelines is not out. So people might be of this idea that our ministers are not wearing, so we might not. So maybe those guidelines that they are following has to be put in public. And they should also, I think, when it is not necessary, they should take out the mask. They should not take out.
Okay. What is the speciality of today?
1st August.
Yeah, I know that. Everyone of us know. Got 2-3 special things today.
Sir, today I've read the good news is that our Olympics hockey team for women has got into the quarterfinals. And apart from this, I am unable to recall. Sir.
Today is Islam Women Day. It is observed. Today is Tilak's death centenary. Today is the launch of non-cooperation movement by Gandhi.
And today is India is presiding over the UNSC Security yes. Council also.
Okay. Meghna, is pandemic gender neutral?
Ma'am, the virus in itself is gender neutral, but the precautions that we are taking and the steps we are taking through vaccination, etc., I am seeing that it is not being gender neutral, ma'am.
Can you elaborate?
Yes. So, ma'am, there has been this report that within the vaccination, the rate of vaccination among men is higher than the rate of vaccination among women. Where men who are working in their houses, they are able to take the vaccination at their houses, etc. That is one point. Second, the effects of the pandemic. Ma'am, there has been this data from this EMI saying that the loss of job has been particularly very large for women and not for men. And thirdly, being a student of sociology, where there is this term called double work that women get to do at homes, that has increased very drastically in the pandemic, where they had to do the house core jobs in a greater sense, in the sense that students' education now has completely moved drastically from teacher to the female mother usually more. So in these senses, I think that the pandemic has not been the effects of the pandemic has not been gender neutral.
There has been demand of caste-based census. So what is your opinion about it?
Ma'am, with the changing time and how our society has been changing, learning and knowing about the new social realities, I believe, is a good step forward. And the caste census would definitely help in that way. What is the demography? What are the social and economic standards of a caste will help.
In your hobby, you have mentioned thread bangles.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you tell a bit about it?
like the bangles or how I started?
Yeah, how you make them.
So, we take rough bangles, the plastic bangles or any raw material which is little cheap, and then we, then what we used to do is we get a thread, usually a silk and a little thicker thread. And the best thing about the thread bangles is that whatever sari you are making, sari you are going to wear, you can get the exact color of the thread, which we usually do not get find in bangles. Holding two bangles together and binding them with this thread, and on top of that we use Faber-Castell's fabric gum, and then we put up some nice designs over it on the bangle.
Okay, any idea of ODOP? ODOP.
ODOP?
Yeah. One district, one product.
Oh, yes ma'am. Yes, yes. So it is given in the recent budget and the tranche that the finance minister has given during the pandemic times. It was said that if each district is given a specification, we will be able to better brand the product and better sell the product. And our honorable finance minister ma'am, she is also mentioned that Telangana is known for turmeric, so we should go by having the good products and the specific products we have to pick from a district and then market them.
Meghna, I'm seeing this R value in news. R value with respect to COVID.
R value, the rate of
transmission. Explain what you understand by R value.
R naught value, so the rate of transmission, like right. If it is more than one, so you will be giving it to more one person more. If it is more than two, then you will be able to, you are transmitting the disease to two people.
Okay. Today I came across this news that, you know, 120, 130 crore rupees have been wasted by the opposition installing the parliament. Have you read this?
No.
Parliament is being stalled. You are aware of this. Who is responsible?
Sir, I would not say that it is a responsibility of one person, but the opposition is demanding certain aspects to be discussed, and the contention is that the way of opposing or the way of asking for those is not right. So there's been a debate, and the opposition and the ruling is not on the same side on this issue.
Okay. So ITC as a company, if you can give me a breakup of what share of its revenue comes from different streams, from cigarettes, from hospitality, do you have an idea?
Yes, sir. So cigarettes has been mostly the main cash cow for ITC. Nearly 70% of our revenues come from cigarettes, and within cigarettes, Gold Flakes amounts to nearly again 65% to 70% of the revenues, and then around 10% comes from the food business, sir. And the hotels make a very small share, and PCP is the personal care products in ITC, Fiamma, Savlon, Vivel Devil. Sir, I've been told recently that till the time I was there, it was usually a loss making. I mean, investment, we were putting more investments and the returns were less. But especially during the pandemic times, with the Savlon revenues going high, it was said that it is also started making profit.
So, what kind of steps is ITC taking to address this problem of smoking and addiction of smoking?
Sir, firstly, the company is trying to diversify under the guidance of our late leadership, Mr. Y.C. Deveshwar. The company has moved away from the cigarettes and is increasingly investing into the foods and personal care and the other segments. Sir, the new segments of ITC have been into the food cold chain. So it is working on that, sir. And secondly, one of the things that I had worked in ITC and observed is ITC steps, especially in the cigarette sector, have been always moral and legal. So there have been a lot of companies and a lot of underground activities which happen in this sector, in the cigarette and tobacco sector. But the company always remains true to the legal ways of going in the space market.
Any CSR activity to deal with the non-communicable diseases associated?
I'm unaware of it, sir, but I must be doing them.
We see a trend in Western countries, especially in US, there's a legalization of marijuana. and culturally there's a lot of consumption of marijuana in religious places. What do you think about legalization of marijuana in India?
Sir, there are two phases about it. The first point of discussion is that it is the liberty, a person's liberty to choose. But also there is a social public morality and public order which is goes out of the window when this marijuana goes out.
Because we already consume during festivals in religious places. I think it's highly consumed.
Yes, sir. But in this, when we have it in the culture, the thing is that we have the cult structures which make sure that they do not go out of bond. Suppose a person is consuming it near the temple activities, it is very unlikely that the person would go out into the road and make a scene or something like that. So I think there are certain cultural structures also to stop these activities to go out of hand. But when we do legalize the system and we allow everyone to consume, then we do not have those structures to stop. And also our literacy rate also will be important over there, where when the joblessness and literacy is less, so certain activities can, the problem that we see in Punjab today, so that can lead to very bad consequences in the end of the day.
You've seen or heard about application of AI in a wide variety of areas. Can you tell me some areas where it is not very popularly known where AI is applied? In anything which is not popularly known, which you have come across watching documentaries on AI?
Sir, one is in the health sector, that AI is being, in the Western nations, it is being used for detecting cancers. It is not so widely known in India. And Apollo Group companies from Hyderabad is wanting to get that technology. That is one, sir. And secondly, in the supply chain, the quality checks in the Western nations are now happening through artificial intelligence, sir. So usually in the warehouses, a person physically maintains the quality checks, but with AI, they are able to remove those barriers and do it with a machine.
Any Indian healthcare company using AI? Anything you are aware of?
Sir, I'm aware that they are using, but I'm not very sure which company is using. Even pharma companies are using for their demand management, etc.
Okay, Meghna, your interview is over.